before I got your support. I hopped off the porch around the time that y'all got awards. Lyrical exercise, this what I call a sport. The fourth bar, brother, when I push the rock off the court. I got champion genetics. Remember me. Of a star, they hear my name and remember me. Remember me. I am the player. Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything. I am the player. You seen the making of a star, they hear my name and remember me. Remember me. I am the player. Just let the record show that I said I'm coming for everything. The chatter mouse whose talent don't average out. If your flow ain't nowhere near this caliber, that don't count. Competition get flattened out. Getting money like I went top three in the first round. My salary that amount. They want my style, but that ain't much to be flat about. I take it as a challenge when rappers calling my status out. One of the best, and they ain't my pedigree. You can have the...
It's Madden NFL 23 on EA Sports, and there's no love lost between these NFC South foes. It's the New Orleans Saints and the Carolina Panthers, and it's all up next.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL has us at the venerable Superdome in downtown New Orleans. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the New Orleans Saints and the Carolina Panthers. Again, everybody, alongside my partner Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. And Charles, when you and I were going through our final run-throughs at breakfast, we kept thinking tonight we're going to get to see a couple of very good passing offenses.
And we're talking about both sides having multiple receivers that could have an impact on this game. It's not just one guy that's going to make all the plays. If you take him away, maybe number two, number three, they make the big plays that impact who wins the game.
Florida Gator Eddie Pinheiro to get us started, and we are underway from the Superdome. Taken at the goal line, and he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. And here come the Saints for their opening drive. They're led out by a three-time Pro Bowler, owner of over 35,000 passing yards in 11 seasons, the veteran Andy Dalton.
I love his football IQ. I love his ability to have people rally around him. And as he likes to remind me all the time when I get ready to call one of his games, I can run it a little bit too. A nice presence to have on your team.
Dalton right to the air.
Looking left side, that's caught by Landry. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. 19 yards right off the bat, and a quick first down.
But how about this throw right here? Had to throw it to the left sideline, and you know the timing's got to be correct on this one. Ball's got to be right where it needs to be, and it was. That's because he had great arm strength on that one, able to drive the football. Quarterbacks love it when they can show off their arms.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. A first carry now. This is Alvin Kamara. And the big boys up front, they're going to stop him right at the line. Big Derek Brown making the stop.
And the big fella stuffed that one up in a big way. I think doubling him has to be a priority because you can't move up to the next level if you don't take care of him first.
Dalton's throw taken in by Landry. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. The Panthers turn to their nickel set here as they get ready for third down. To throw here, Dalton. Johnson's got it complete. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30.
Well, a lot of times when you get a manageable third down situation like this, you have to think about your tight end, and he comes through for him, picking up the first down. First down,
line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the gun, it's a run for Kamara. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Vitor Gross-Matos there to bring him down.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up here in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately, he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
They'll get this out to Kamara. And he's brought down here just outside of the 20. Safe to say the passing game has found a rhythm. He's now 4-4, but might need to be 5-5 to keep this drive going here as they face a third down.
And maybe perhaps you show a running play, right? Maybe a little play action here to go ahead and let him throw the ball downfield. I wouldn't get away from him flinging it because 4-4 already, I think he's got a good chance of picking this one up here on third down.
Just a gain of a couple, but good enough to keep the drive rolling. Well, they kept it simple there, CD, only needing the short gain to move the chain, so they didn't want to go with a deep throw. They just go with that safer, shorter throw and able to convert.
Nothing wrong with that at all, partner. Check the box, right? Make sure you pick up the first down. Offense is getting established. You're moving the ball. You're not turning it over. Check, check, check. They like what they're doing early in the game.
So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Dalton operating in the red zone now. Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
No sense risking anything there on first down. Even though he's still in the pocket, he had a receiver out to his side, so just put that in a spot where the only people who could make a play on it are the trainers and the coaches. Well done.
And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. That gain of 15 gets him on the doorstep, first and goal.
A lot of precision being shown on this opening drive. They've been methodical, they've been crisp, and as a reward, they're going to be set up with an early first and goal.
First and goal, a chance for an early statement here on the road. Kamara will get about halfway there as he takes this from the 4 down to the 2. Give him 3 on the gain there, second and goal.
Here's where we need to see some tenacity from this defense because they've been pushed right down the field on this opening drive. They've got to find some way to push back, and that's a good first step.
And he is not going to get in as the big bodies stop him at the 1. They're held again, and do we have a goal line stand brewing? It's third and goal. They were stopped last time from the 1. Now here's another try on third and goal. Despite only needing 1, Dalton to throw. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Juwan Johnson, a 1-yard touchdown reception. And the Saints will claim the early lead as they're on the board first here tonight. That was a big throw right there on third and goal.
And the defense has to be prepared for you to throw the ball on third and goal. Because really, second down, second and goal, that's your play action time. And you're not sure whether they're going to run it or throw it. Third down, you're usually sure they're probably going to pass it. Even more impressive that they got it done. And on the opening drive of the game.
Lutz with the extra point. And it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line. So here are the Panthers under head coach Matt Rhule. And they'll be led out by Sam Darnold in his 5th year now out of USC.
And the thing with Sam Darnold is we know the skill set is there. May not be the most mobile or strongest arm quarterback in the league, but usually plays with really good poise and at his best, like a point guard in basketball, able to move around and distribute the rock.
Darnold and the Panthers now with a first and 10 here at their own 21. Here's Darnold. He'll find his man, Terrace Marshall, complete.
So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and they'll be left with 2nd and a couple.
Brandon, to me, what's important right here on this drive is for them to get at least 2 first downs. They've got to give their defense a chance to settle down, catch their breath a little bit after they give up a touchdown on the opening drive.
Darnold's throw pulled in by Marshall,
and he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Give him 18. It's a Carolina first down.
So we just called his name on the previous snap, and they go right back to him, Charles, for a 2nd consecutive completion.
Yeah, I think what we're discovering on this drive is that he feels like he has answers no matter what defense you throw up there. He reads it, finds the open spot, and is available for the completion.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Darnold.
A quick throw knocked away. It's incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage. Able to knock that one away.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a 2nd and 10. Darnold to throw again.
He gets this one to Hubbard. Complete. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43.
And forget about the run to set up the pass. They're just coming out throwing.
Forget trying to set anything up. They feel like they have the advantage. They feel like they have the matchups, and they're just attacking right now.
Yep, going to the air on the opening drive. Darnold will throw it on 3rd and 1. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. The drive stays alive. A 3rd down gain of 8.
Solid opening drive so far, Charles. They've moved this football into field goal range, but you know that they want to cap this off with 6 and not 3.
Absolutely. As one of the better coaches in the league always tells me, on offense, I want their body blows all game long and finish it with uppercuts. Well, here are the body blows right now. He's hoping one uppercut will take care of the end of this drive.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. To throw is Darnold. Firing quickly, but it's incomplete. That's already the 3rd time they've looked his way on this opening drive. He's caught 1 of the 3.
That doesn't mean they won't continue to go in that direction. It feels like they think they've got something good going there, and they think those numbers are going to increase.
To throw again on 2nd down, Darnold. His throw incomplete.
How about that? Red man coverage. He decided to test him early, but it proved up to the task and forced the incompletion.
This offense was on the move. Now 2 straight incompletions have him looking at 3rd and 10. To the air again, Darnold. And that will be incomplete as well.
This defense has certainly played well so far in this game, and the coverage has been tight on just about every throw. Forced a few here so far in this game, and now it brings up 4th down.
Now for the field goal try. Here's Eddie Pinheiro. He'll be spotted on the right hash. A 52-yard attempt. And he'll try and throw here on the fake. And they're able to pick up the 1st and keep possession. So not only do they convert on 4th, but they pick up 22 yards in the process.
Did that totally surprise you after the meeting we had with the head coach this week?
Well, he talked about being aggressive, but opening drive of the game to fake a field goal, that's very aggressive.
Yeah, you're right. I'm probably trying to act like I knew a little bit more there. He caught me off guard as well, but looking back on it, he did tell us in our meeting he planned to be very aggressive in this game, and there's a terrific example of it.
So after the big play on 4th, here's 1st and 10.
from the red zone now. They'll look to throw.
And that one off the mark behind him. Incomplete.
Anytime he reads man coverage, I don't think it's going to be the only time he'll try and hit that route to the outside in this game. He'll test the perimeter. But that time, they were up to the challenge.
On second and 10, Darnold. He gets it to Thomas.
And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line.
I'm wondering if the same thing went through your mind as mine. When I see a big man like that make a catch, all I keep thinking to myself is, big man with football. Look out, everyone. He may not juke you a whole lot, right? He may not run past you because of his size. You talk about a guy weighing in the 270 range. But boy, once he gets his mitts on the ball, he's going to be tough to bring down.
They're able to convert on third down, and that sets up a first and goal.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball across the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
First and goal, and a chance to get that initial touchdown right back.
They'll run here with Hubbard.
And he is in. Touchdown, Carolina.
Chuba Hubbard
taking it in from a yard out.
And the Panthers respond to that opening drive touchdown with one of their own. He finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three down, stay on the field, run it, and catch it. And he gets it done.
Eddie Pinheiro now for the extra point. It's up and good. So these teams match touchdowns here in the first quarter, and we're tied 7-7. So that one, a 13-play drive in total.
And it was Chuba Hubbard who finished it off with a touchdown run.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away.
This taken in at the goal line.
And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. New Orleans Saints, they get ready to set up shop for their second drive.
So both of these teams, Charles, coming off touchdowns now, but this offense, they just had to stand on the sideline, watch their opponent offer a really impressive drive to reach the end zone.
Yeah, and I think you're not telling yourself the truth if you don't think there's some one-upsmanship going on right now, because they just had their touchdown answered by a drive of double-digit plays that also found the end zone. Now they want to do something even more impressive to answer that one.
Those are the types of runs they told us they want to see more of. Look, they love the 60 to 70-yard runs, but those 10 to 20-yarders, they can help you win a ball game.
And that means everyone's invested, because you know the big guys up front, that's what they do. They try and move people. But when you get your perimeter guys involved downfield, that means that they care about the running game and they know it helps their team.
Staying on the ground on first with Kamara. And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
7-7, our score after one.
The Saints with a football here to begin quarter number 2. As they've got it with a second and 3 forthcoming. Dalton now to pass over the middle and into the hands of his receiver Landry.
And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 48-yard line. They'll pound it up the middle with Kamara. And they'll get this just to the 47. 1 yard gain.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. Again, it's Kamara. He'll get about four here, down to the 43-yard line.
If you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
Here's Dalton. Open man is Michael Thomas. And he is going to have a Saints first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
As an unbiased observer, I think it would have been interesting to see what they would have done if they hadn't gotten the first down there. But since they did, I guess the point is moot.
And they're right there in that middle ground, field goal range, punt, go for it. But as you said, they picked it up.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Passing, it's Dalton. Here's Johnson with a reception. And they are able to stop him, but he does take it all the way to the 2. 33 yards that time.
You ask tight ends about their favorite routes to run, and surprisingly, this will pop up as one of their staples because they run so many routes in the middle of the field. How about this one? Starts downfield, bends it to the corner. Great touch on the football, and they turn that one into a big play.
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the 2. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Back at the 2 now. Here's second and goal. So Dalton now. Oh, that'll be incomplete.
Well, he took a shot as he let that go.
And it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, to me, there was no question about the intent there. And I think he was a little fortunate that the penalty flag didn't come out for grounding. But he'll get away with it and get another shot on third down.
They'll run it with Kamara. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Alvin Kamara taking it in from 2 yards out. And the Saints had taken the lead.
But he decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times that's a passing play.
And the kicker just has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Lutzel looked to add the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. So the drive goes 75 yards, 10 plays. And the capper came from Alvin Kamara on the touchdown run. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. On the return, Andre Roberts from his end zone. And they'll get him down right at the 25-yard line, so the same result, and he opted for the touchback. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their second drive. So remember, Charles, last time they were out here, they scored, but they just saw the opposition score, and they're trailing right now, so they're trying to keep pace here. They need a touchdown drive.
Well, if you're a fan of offense, you're loving this, but if you're a fan of defense, this is tough to watch, and it's also tough to keep that up when you just watch your opponent march down the field on a scoring drive that lasts into double-digit snaps. You need to score here, not just to follow the momentum from your last drive, but put the onus back on your opponent. And that's what they're doing right now, swapping that onus back and forth.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. To throw once more on second and 10. Darnold. That helps the completion percentage, but not much else. And now it's third and 10. But he caught it right at the line of scrimmage. And before he could even think about advancing it forward, he got hit.
Great tackling, because that's what you're taught. Don't give up yards after the catch. And most offenses make a living off of yards after catches. Hidden yards that may not go into the score sheet, but they count big for moving the ball, stretching the field. Really nice open field tackle. And this is what you want to see from a defense. Give up an opening drive touchdown? That's fine. But how about them going back out there, recommitting themselves to the task at hand, and forcing a three and out and giving the ball back to their offense?
On is the punter, Hecker, as he gets this one away. A 48-yard punt, 7 on the return. And the Saints will take over with a first down and 10. Now this offense back out and set to go for their next drive. So for this offense, Charles, remember, drive one made it to the end zone. Drive two resulted in a touchdown as well. Now they'll try to make it 3 for 3.
Yeah, and you know, they told us all week that this was the plan and this is what they wanted to execute, but did they really believe it would happen this well, this efficiently? I know they'll take it, and afterwards they'll say, there's never a doubt in our minds we were going to be successful in this one.
They may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down.
So many times in my career I've heard coaches talk about completions are one thing. As long as we're there at the catch and we get guys on the ground, we can live with that. But if you're going to give up 10, 12, 15 yards after the catch, then your defense is going to be in a lot of trouble.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Andy Dalton. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down.
You've always been very good about checking my math. Am I correct? That's the first time that it's been incomplete when they've thrown it to him?
Yes, he had caught every other ball coming his way.
So they feel like they've got something really good going there, and they're going to continue to go there until the defense makes an adjustment and takes it away.
Well, they finally made an adjustment there. We'll see if they can build on that stuff. And they're going to have another first down as the tackle's made at the Panthers' 38-yard line. That one good for 16 as the drive continues.
And this was a nice example of an offensive coordinator scheming his guy open, just a little underneath route, just trying to free up some space, and it worked awfully well. Got him not just space, but plenty of room to run after the catch to pick up really nice yardage.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 38. They'll run out of the gun with Kamara. And he finds a little bit of room, enough for 4 yards. It'll be second down.
And that was a quality play to start a new set of downs. That was simply an offensive line winning the battle up front and winging in a big way and giving their guy in the backfield a nice lane to hit.
And he'll get a little over 2, maybe a full 3 down to the 32-yard line. The Saints on third down. No problems to this point. A perfect 5 for 5. This is 3rd and 4. Out of the gun, it's Dalton. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he is going to have a Saints first down by about 3 yards or so as they wind up getting 7 there on 3rd and 4.
And that one was a lot of fun right there because that was the game within the game. 3rd and short, blitz was on. What's the key for the quarterback? Get out of your hands in a hurry. And that was a quick little completion. Got the job done for a first down.
Now Dalton with a 1st and 10. Slant pass complete to Olave. And he's brought down inside the 20 at the 18-yard line.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent type of a play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed, because you hit a guy on the run like that, you often can go for big yardage.
Sets him up nicely for second down, staying ahead of schedule. To throw again on second down, Dalton. And he's got the hook up to Landry. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. Starting to rack up the yardage here in this first half. 5 catches now and a first down.
But one of the ways the quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
They scored touchdowns on drives 1 and 2, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. Here's Dalton. That one thrown away from the pocket. The officials kind of looking at each other, but they say there was a receiver in the area, so no penalty, just an incomplete pass. On second and goal, Dalton, and his throw is going to be incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time. The crowd here in the dome making things difficult. Third and goal. And again, Andy Dalton to throw. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. 1:57 to go in this first half on EA Sports. So on fourth down, on comes Saints kicker Will Lutz. From the left hash, a chip shot here. The kick by Lutz is good, and they will move up by 10 now, 17-7. So that one on target, and it adds to this first half lead.
And maybe we're too early to worry too much about one score lead, two score lead, etc. But this is where you kind of start banking those points that come in helpful later on.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And taken down just past the 20 at about the 21-yard line. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. They trail by 10, 17-7 as they come up on a first and 10. Job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after. Ball at the 23, second and 8. Now it's Darnold. And he will find the open man. It's DJ Moore. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down.
Sometimes it's designed, and sometimes you just have to know when to leave the pocket and move and make something happen. And on that play, he was able to get on the run and was still accurate throwing the football.
First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get 3 out of this, something about whittling it to a one-score game at half that might provide a psychological boost. Faking the give, Darnold. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Marshall. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line.
As a general rule, offensive linemen like to know where their quarterback's going to be when he's setting up to throw the football. Sometimes they just have to get on the run, get on the move. He was able to do that on that play and picks up a first down with a nice throw.
On first down, it's Darnold. Throw left side complete. That's Moore. And he'll be taken down at about the 22-yard line. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game.
As we'll get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports Halftime Report.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome, everyone, to our brand-new studios here in downtown Orlando in the EA Sports Halftime Report. First things first, let's get a check on the next-gen stats from that first half for the Saints. And they've had all sorts of success thus far tonight throwing the football, as they're on pace to throw for 300-plus yards if they continue the way they've been going. Both teams going through their final halftime adjustments. We're about ready to get back to football. And to bring you the second half from the Superdome, let's go back to Brandon and Char.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. Fields it right around the goal line, and he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter.
Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing in the ground attack either. So certainly something has to change here in quarter three.
And I'm pretty sure their friends from the defensive side of the ball told them exactly that, because those guys, the stop troops, they've been playing pretty well. They've kept them around in this game. Now they got some time. The game scored. They've got to re-energize that ground game and maybe open things up for a comeback here in this half.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. Right back to Hubbard. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, but that's all they needed to move the sticks.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield, because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Darnold on first down. And that'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'll guarantee he quietly has told them, you might want to stop coming after me downfield, because I just broke up another pass and took away a big shot that you were trying to succeed with.
And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done, because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play. The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
And how about this, a fake? And this is going to blow up in their faces. Not only do they not get the first, they're going to lose big yardage as well.
So a definite surprise there. They try the fake punt, but this time it's going to blow up in their face, CD.
Yeah, certainly has. And look, I understand what they're trying to do. They're trailing right now, probably trying to generate some momentum. But that felt like one of those go-for-broke type of a plays in a situation where I don't know that they needed to do that. They still have opportunities, and in this case, they took a chance, and it backfired.
Dalton sets up play action. Blitz coming, and down he goes. Brian Burns flying in there and dropping it for the sack.
This defense coming out after the half, and if that plays any indicator, Charles, maybe a little refreshed and refocused here for quarters three and four.
Yeah, they did really well on that one. That's exactly what they need to keep doing if they want to change their fortunes in this game.
So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. Another try after the first down sack. Dalton firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he'll be brought down at the 27. The chance of wasting this great starting field position, a real threat. This is third and long. And Dalton to throw. Looking for the end zone. And unable to connect. Incomplete. I'll give them credit. They took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Will Lutz now to try the New Orleans field goal. He hit his first one. This from 44 yards out now. The kick by Lutz is good. And that will open the lead up now to 20-7. So the big return had him fired up, but in the end, the offense stalls out. They only muster three.
Yeah, the excitement was there after the return, but they didn't move the ball at all after that. They didn't even get a first down.
Following the made field goal, Lutz to kick it away. Here's Roberts to bring it out of the end zone. And his guys will get the football right at the 20-yard line. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. Darnold and the Panthers now with a first and 10 here at their own 20-yard line. They'll start the drive with a give to Foreman. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again second and 10. Here's Darnold. And this one incomplete. Too much contact to hold on to that one, and it's third down.
As soon as he leaked out and began his route, someone on the defensive side broke with him and arrived just in time to separate him from another reception.
Throwing here on third down, Darnold. He's going to look deep for more. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
I'm sure this isn't a novel thought, but maybe run some simpler routes instead of trying to get it all back in one shot. Defense certainly appears to be ready for him. Try and get it back little by little instead of in big chunks.
Here's Johnny Hecker now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Fair catch called for in May, but now we'll have to see about the penalty.
Kick catch interference. Kicking.
A little too amped up there. Got to him before he had a chance to catch it.
Another example of players in tough spots getting the protection that they deserve. Got to make sure that he's able to catch the ball before you get to him.
A lack of discipline defensively on fourth down, and now that leads to a first and 10. Now Dalton. And he'll get this one underneath to Kamara. And he's going to be down at the 35. Gain of 7. Working with a second and 3. To throw here, Dalton. Drives it left side and finds Olave. And he'll be brought down at the 27. Dalton, first and 10. That's Olave bringing in another one. And he's going to be marked down just outside the 10.
And now we get into the psychology of the whole thing, because a lot of teams with a two-score lead in the third quarter, they almost become defensive with their offense, just playing not to lose. I think with this team, you got to figure at this point, this is a great spot for them to go into attack mode, really try and put the hammer down and finish this one off.
Now a first and 10 at the 11. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw. And that is caught on the right sideline, but out of bounds, says the line judge. The throw took him a little too far. It's second down. This will be Dalton again. They'll set up the screen now to Kamara.
And he's going to be brought down just shy of the 5 at the 6.
Boy, that one was well-read defensively. This is all about diagnosis as a safety and being decisive, because he saw it setting up in front of him, able to knife through there and make the play.
They'll need 5 on this play to move the sticks. Throwing, Dalton. And he wisely will throw that one away.
These guys have decided to do it for the last time moving the ball down the field. They may have to do it again on this drive. That could be frustrating.
Yeah, I don't want to be cliche, but at least they were able to get 3 last time. 3 here, not the worst thing in the world. The kick by Lutz is good, and that will extend their lead even further. A second field goal here in this third quarter, and his 3rd of the game so far.
He's been an important part of the offense, that's for sure, and they may need him again before this one's said and done. So I would treat him like a pitcher throwing a no-hitter. Leave him alone and let him focus.
Fielded just outside the goal line. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. I would say they went 3 and out last time, but actually they didn't even get to 3 and out. Still a strange decision to us here in the booth.
Yeah, let's hope they don't go 1 and out, but maybe, possibly, let's try and think with them here. Try to play field position maybe, turn the ball over, put it in the hands of their defense, who knows?
You're a nice man. Darnold and the Panthers now with a 1st and 10 here at their own 22. Here's Darnold. He's got a man. That's Marshall. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Give him 30 yards there.
Still all sorts of time left in this game, and you'd like to be able to say take it one play at a time. But the truth is, they're probably going to have to hit on a few big plays in the passing game to close this gap, and that's a good start right there.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up 1st and 10. To throw is Darnold. He gets this one to Hubbard, complete. And the tackle going to be made at the 38.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
On 2nd and very short, Darnold. That's going to be caught. It's Chenault. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. 22 yards there, a 1st down.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going. A little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
So the ball down to the 16 here for 1st and 10. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
As a corner, you have to be able to run with guys step for step downfield of man coverage and make up ground quickly in zone. You have to put yourself in position to make plays just like that one we saw there.
Throwing again is Darnold. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Laviska Shenault, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Panthers are able to cut into that deficit. So a tiptoe catch back of the end zone, so tough to do, but he made it look pretty easy.
Certainly did, and the back of the end zone is treated the same way as the sideline. You have to get your feet down in bounds for it to count as a catch. How about the backgrounds of some of these guys, though? Did they work out? Maybe someone were ballet, some dance, who knows?
Yeah, you and I were talking the other day. I remember one of my favorite kid shows growing up. I don't know that I want to name it, but guys like Len Swan, they used to be on there showing their ballet skill.
And you have to remember when they were kids and their parents would tell them to take the ballet classes, you know they were fighting them like crazy. But right now they're saying, thanks, Mom.
Now Matt Rhule keeping the offense on the field to go for two here.
They're going to keep it on the ground. And he's going to go down right at the line of scrimmage. The defense left him with nowhere to go. And the try for two is denied. Touchdown. Here's Pinheiro to kick it off. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Out is the Saints offense now as they get ready to take over here. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Andy Dalton. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to go 3 and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, Old Momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trek to the opposite side, and all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
Now a third down throw, but he misses the target, incomplete.
And that's a caution right there. Has been open for a first down. Throw a fastball, but that wasn't necessary. Incomplete pass. When are these quarterbacks going to learn? You don't get extra points for how hard you throw the football.
Here comes the Saints punter now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. To return is Roberts. He almost outkicked the coverage. A 57-yard punt, 15 on the return. And the Panthers will take over now, first and 10. The Carolina offense about ready to go. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now looking for Marshall, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Paulson Adebo. And the Saints are going to take possession of the football.
Well, this had trouble written all over from the start. He's got two extra defensive backs in the game he's got to deal with. They're in a dime set. So everywhere he's looking, he's seeing a different color jersey. And sure enough, this one winds up being intercepted.
The New Orleans offense set to take over. No points last time out. They were forced to punt, if you remember, but no time to dwell on that. They've still got the lead here and a chance to add to that here. First and 10 as this new drive starts. Now a first down carry. It's Kamara. And he gets forward up the middle, but only for a couple. Maybe second down. The last run good for two. Here's second and 8. It's Dalton. And Thomas has it. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
He decided to run a hitch route. It really helped to have a guy who can turn it loose. And boy, he rifled one in there on that one. Not much run after catch, but it worked really well.
Here's Kamara trying to run for it. Only a pickup of 2, but that's all they needed for the first.
3rd and 2, right? So this is a situation where low man has got to win at the line of scrimmage. But it's not just the low man winning. It's the low man who's winning with some force. And they had that to pick up the first down.
Barely picking it up, but they did. We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now here live in New Orleans.
It's the Saints. They'll be looking to expand their lead here. They've got the football as we start the fourth. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. So Dalton now. Now they go screen. It's complete. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line.
And good yardage there on first down, because sometimes all you need to do on the screen is get one key block. That might set your man free, and that was pretty good pursuit to the football defensively. Or it could have gone for more.
Throwing again on second down, but this time it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Now throwing on third down, he cannot connect. And the other day they told us we got 4 or 5 of us. We have to be able to convert. And I guess every team would say that, Charles, but an opportunity miss there.
What they were trying to tell us is they believe it's a matchup game at that point, and they liked some matchups that they had, thought they could exploit them, unable to do so on that play.
Now they go for it on fourth, but this one is going to wind up incomplete. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires, and the Panthers will get the football back. And I am not sure, partner, there what the mindset was to go for it. I don't know.
And some teams just feel that possession is the key to everything. They just want to have the football in their hands. No matter how it goes to the other team, they just don't trust doing that. So they say, listen, go for it and try and finish it ourselves.
Darnold and the Panthers now with a first and 10 here at their own 26. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. A quick throw knocked away and incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time, separation. That's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Throwing again on second and 10. Darnold. And that nearly intercepted. It's incomplete. Now remember, he had a pick earlier, but couldn't reel that one in. The offense on third down tonight, they've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This is third and 10. Trying to fit it into Moore, but it's intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And the Saints are going to take possession of the football. And here in the fourth quarter, defensively, you know that you're just going to blanket the field with defensive backs and say, okay, take your best shot. And that time, it's intercepted.
And we've often seen teams go into the prevent early, way too early. And sometimes they get too soft in their coverages. But not in this case. They understood the situation and played it with the proper aggression.
The busy night continues for Kamara. And he'll get what he can up the middle, 3 yards, and that'll bring up second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. They run it again with Kamara. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
7 catches for him now. This last one, the first down. He's been the go-to guy. They needed a big play there on third down. Went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they've scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
So first and 10 now from the 30. A give to Kamara running right. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards. Back to the 33. A loss of a full 3 yards. And now it's second down.
That's not an easy play for a defensive end, because most of his responsibility has him getting upfield and working. But how about his vision to see where the play was going? Crashed down inside and tackled him for a loss.
After the loss, they'll come up second and 13. Play action here with Dalton. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line.
Vitor Gross-Matos getting in there to make the play.
So that time, Charles, a quarterback helpless really in the pocket in the face of a pass rush like that. They were on him instantly.
Yeah, that's one where you turn to your wife and say, guys, can I get a little help here? And you have to ask politely because, remember, they're blocking for you the entire game. But as a quarterback, you've also got to have the clock running in your head when you need to get rid of the football. But this time, he had no chance. They were on him instantly.
And as we check the next-gen stats, that play lasted just 2.7 seconds from beginning to end. It's not enough time to throw the football.
Not sure what happened out there, but it looked like the timing was a little off on that throw.
Well, you know I'm a defender, so what am I going to say?
Great defense.
Darn right. They did something to disrupt that timing.
And this is off target to the left. Didn't get there anyway. It's no good. And the lead will hold at 10. Charles, all things considered, I guess that's not a critical miss at this stage, is it?
No, but still everything helps when you're trying to finish off a ball game. And you're right. Not critical in terms of the scoreboard and the team. But the guy with the golden foot, he knows he's only as good as his last kick.
The possession of the football goes over to Carolina. Well, they didn't fall behind any further thanks to that missed field goal, but still staring at this fourth quarter deficit. They've got good starting field position as they come up here first and 10, just shy of midfield at the 48. Now Darnold. Throw left side, going to be caught by Chenault. And they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
Looking to throw again on second down. Darnold, he gets it to Thomas. It'll be a gain of 5, and that'll leave him with a third and just a yard.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Darnold will throw it on third and 1. And a quick throw here. That's complete. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And a two-score game, obviously, every play, every third down, like we saw there, magnified big pickup.
It was a huge pickup. What they really want, though, is to not even get to third down. They've got to maximize time and conserve as much as possible.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Darnold to throw again. And nowhere to fit that football in. It's knocked away and incomplete.
Textbook coverage right there. Played the ball, never lost sight of where it was headed, and stayed in perfect position to make a play on it. Able to keep the receiver and the quarterback in his sight lines.
To throw on second and 10. Darnold. And that's complete to the right side. It's Marshall. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's made at the Saints 18. They give up 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Well, every drive from here out is definitely crucial and critical. They know that they need to get at least 3 here to get it back to a one-score game. But I can't imagine that in their huddle that they're thinking at all about getting a field goal. They want to get into the end zone and then try to get the ball back again.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. That is caught inside the 5. And the Panthers are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
Well, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Hubbard diving for the end zone, and he'll get there. Touchdown. He's having a nice little game. Maybe already has an eye on that third touchdown.
And how about what our producer, Christian McLeod, likes to say when they score touchdowns like this? He's put a tent up in Touchdown City.
Pinheiro now to add the extra point.
And the lead is down to a field goal now. So this drive spans 7 plays.
And it was Chuba Hubbard who finished it off with a touchdown run.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off. And he won't return this one. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start at the 25. Now the Saints offense, they get ready to go back to work here.
And with that last touchdown, I mean, we're set up for a good finish here. Some things to consider, Charles. Obviously, it's a very close game here in the fourth quarter. Defensively, they've got all 3 timeouts in their back pocket.
So the chess match really ramps up, doesn't it? Because in these situations, what do? Do you run the ball and kill the clock here? Or do you try and bury them with another score? And how about defensively? Do you use your timeouts and early opportunity? Or wait till you hit the 2-minute warning? So there's a lot going into this one. Let's see how each side goes about their strategy.
From the 27, Dalton. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 63 yards receiving for him now. And that last catch, good enough for a first down.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
Trying to run down some clock with Kamara. And they will only muster a yard here to the 38. Well, the objective there, I mean, yes, the positive gain, that's nice, but work some clock.
Yeah, you're exactly right. But the problem for them is still within a possession. So they can't just sit on it running the ball. They'll have to find a way to throw it effectively as well.
And he's going to have to protect the football and take his lumps here at this stage of the game as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to 3rd and 10.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key 3rd down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key 3rd down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. They're facing a critical 3rd down now as they try to hold on to this lead. All right, here's Dalton. And this is caught. He hits Landry. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
But they picked up a little bit of yardage there, and now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
Totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. Trying the left side with Kamara. And he'll wind up getting this to the 32. A play that started at the 16, and that's how many yards they get. 1st down. Great time there to come up with his longest run of the night. We just saw it.
Leads to a lot of satisfaction, because if they're able to hang on and win this game, you know what else will happen in the locker room after this?
What's that?
Head coach will step up and go, great job, guys. Because of that, come in a little bit later tomorrow.
From the 32 now, here's 1st and 10. Kamara up the middle.
And he's got it down to the 28.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
So this one, a victory here for New Orleans. And we talked so much about the turnover battle determining who wins and who loses. This game, no exception. They didn't turn the ball over at all, and they go on to victory.
They looked like a smooth operation in this one, didn't they? Because you look at every facet of the game,
They handled their business. Offense took care of the football, converted it into points. Defense took the ball away, gave it back to the offense. Special teams right there with them. That's the type of game a coach is going to really love and value. And when they show the film, they have to be careful not to give out too many kudos and kill their motivation going forward.